Okay, in the figure, ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, then after that we have the three straight lines. Angle ADB is 36, DEG, DCG is 145, and DAE is 88. Okay, all is already presented in the diagram. Find angle BCG. So we are interested in this particular angle. So for us to get angle BCG, first of all, I would like to find angle. Okay, D. C, B. Okay? Because I know that the full angle here is 145. Once I find this particular angle, I can take 145 minus the angle. So, prior to that, let's be clear that angle, okay, CDB is 36. Because if you have a diagonal cutting across a rhombus, right? Okay? That would be an equal length. So, therefore, immediately, angle DCB, okay? It would be 180 degrees. Okay, this will be isosceles, right? Minus 36 degrees, minus 36 degrees, giving me 108 degrees. Next, angle BCG will then be 145 degrees, minus 108 degrees, leaving behind 37 degrees. Got it? That's for A. Now, let's look at part B. Part B, you are interested to find angle CFA now. So, CFA is this particular angle over here. So, first step. I would like to find angle FAB. Okay, so angle FAB will be 180 degrees minus 88 degrees equals to 20 degrees. And after which, angle ABF, okay, will be easily 180 degrees minus 108 degrees, giving us 72 degrees. Okay, and after which, I will find angle AFB, which is simply 180 degree minus 20 minus 72, giving us 88 degrees. And this allows me to find angle CFA now, because angles on the straight line is 180 degrees. So all in all, angle CFA will just be 180 degree minus 88. Okay, and that will give us 92 degrees. Okay, that is the solution for this question.